Everyone, and welcome to Stephanie Reacts to Game of Thrones. Now this is Game of Thrones, Season 4, Episode 8, The Mountain and the Viper. Well, we're getting close to the finale, the last two episodes after this. Oh, this is where Tyrant Lannister either gets killed or gets free. But as I said in the other videos, I've seen it on my TV, adverts from Game of Thrones for series 7 or series 8 or whatever it is. He's in that, so he either, the Viper either loses and Tyrant somehow escapes, or the Viper wins and gets him set free somehow. But before I begin, sponsored by Cubis, once you try it, you'll go on a diet with carrot juice. Yeah, let's go on with this video. Or be the Lannisters. Be Jaime and that. Oh, a pub. Really? I've seen that episode, Teresa Casimira Hank. I recognize the name. Oh my god. Red.
Who's the man with the name? Too bad you got a hangnail for a cock. First time I saw your breeches down, I thought you were a unit.
So what are we?
Like a baby snail peeking out of his shell.
You're going to sing Oompa-pa? Go for a twist. You're in a bar drinking, somebody was out saying, Oompa-pa, everyone knows. So we go sing, have
we? Baby was crying this morning.
Oh no. No then. Alright, Sam's girlfriend.
You mean me?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, you got anything to say?
I'm sorry he woke you up.
I don't care if you're sorry. Keep that baby quiet.
Well, I will.
Don't you ever
touch. Ooh. Sit it in the bin.
Little wildling bitch. You should have stayed with your own kind. Will you listen to me?
Shut your mouth.
What? It's just an owl, you dumb bitch.
No, it's not.
Is it Sambi coming for her? Made the owl noise to meet her. Well, what is it? Oh my god! Something's happened. Somebody just slit somebody's throat. Whoever he is. Is it a wildling thing? Aye. Whoa! Oh my god, Sam's girlfriend's gonna die, so the main. We're gonna wait for the battle, Viper and the Mountain, but don't see her dying. I died, bitch. Need to touch his wildling child. Come on, recognize! Ooh! No, don't cry. Don't show touch if she recognizes you, maybe. Good girl.
I should never have left her there.
No, you shouldn't have.
Of course I could have known. We've been raiding the villages close by.
We just cower in here while they slaughter our brothers.
Our brothers had orders to stay at Castle Black.
So it's all right then? Black Jack and Kegs and Molly chopped to pieces because they broke the rules.
I didn't say it was all right. I'm saying they shouldn't have been there.
We're pledged to guard the realms of men.
She's dead because of me.
We can't even guard Mole's house.
She's not dead yet, Sam.
I know that. It's what they want.
Little Sam. As if I cut their throats myself.
Maybe she managed to hide herself. I thought one of you was dead. You went up north with Mormon and no one came back. Not for ages. But then you did.
She survived Craster. He was the worst shit I've ever met. She survived the long march to the wall. She survived a white walker, for fuck's sake.
I know, so she survived the Wildling attack.
She might have.
If they hit Mole's town.
You kind of go, Sam, you'll get killed.
Manson's army must be close.
100,000. And there's what? 105 of us left.
You're counting Blackjack, Kegs and Molly. 102.
How do 102 men stop 100,000?
Wildlings. You can't.
Whoever
too much
Black, be a good lad and burn the rest of us. I'm done with this world. I don't want to come back.
Nah, it's a bit walker, you don't. Oh my god, what was that there? Yeah, going for a bath or something? Did I recognise him? But right there, right, horror army. I know who it is now. Change stories. Oh, it's getting cold in here. It's easy. Yeah.
You think he was spying?
Mums?
No, not spying. The Dothraki thing outside is a ridiculous
story.
It's a terrible thing to do to a boy.
If the Master's never caught me, I never am unsullied. I never stand in the Plaza of Pride. When Daenerys Stormborn orders us to kill the Masters, I never am chosen to lead the Unsullied. I never meet Missandei from the Island of Nod.
No, you try. No, you drink this. Cubis.
I am sorry, I, for today. I am sorry.
He's been castrated. Probably worse than his be hers.
Look, another. When Crenny's going in there.
Again, English, please.
Yes, easy.
Right. Theon. Tending.
To
be Theon.
Who are you?
Theon. Hope they don't kill her. His sister tried to save him. Yeah. There's Vessi's okay, sisters.
Commander of this garrison. And you say you're Theon Greyjoy?
Yes.
Why should I believe that?
I was born on Pike to Balon Greyjoy, his third and last living son. I am your prince. I swear it by the drowned god. What is dead may never die.
And if you were my prince, why are you marching with the Bolton army?
Lord Bolton took me captive after Winterfell.
Over the Lady Arryn.
Lady Arryn invited me. She and I have been close since childhood.
Yes, we all know how close you were. Lady Arryn's preparations were her own affair. Her death is our affair.
Of course, her suicide shattered us all.
She was an odd fish. Everyone knew that. But suicide. Mm-hmm. She adores that boy one. Of hers. I don't see her abandoning him. Not by choice.
Strange that within days of your arrival, you married Lady Arryn. And she's fallen through the moon door.
She was always prone to melancholy. My lady wasn't meant for a world as brutal as ours.
We were told there was a witness, a girl.
A niece of yours, I believe.
A girl with no learning and scattered wits, I assure you, she would be of no help.
We'd like to speak with her.
Swanta.
Fetch her.
No need. We prefer to hear her testimony unadulterated.
Right, telling her what to say.
Come closer, child. And I won't say to you. Or him. Lord Baelish here is your uncle. Your name is Alayne?
No.
Perhaps you would feel more comfortable if Lord Baelish left the room.
My lady.
I wasn't asking you.
Speak up, girl. You're not a damn kitchen mouse. Tell us what you saw.
Sorry, Lord Baelish. I have to tell the truth.
Watch out. It won't be the truth, though.
I'll tell you everything.
Please, Alayne. Leave nothing now.
My name's not Alayne.
My name's not Alayne.
It's Sansa
Stark. Eldest daughter of Robert Stark. Lord Royce, we met when you came to Winterfell. You were escorting your son Sir Waymar to the wall.
Sansa Stark? You tell lies right to my face, you little worm.
Lord Baelish has told many lies. All to protect me. Since my father was executed, I have been a hostage in King's Landing. A plaything for Joffrey to torture or Queen Cersei to torment. They beat me, they humiliated me, they married me to the
ill. Spartaned you. It says. And she covered for him.
You could see that's the way she ran that boy. Feeding him from her own teats when he was 10 years old.
Lord Royce.
So be cool. He saved us, so she saved him.
And you as well, Baelish. We treated you a bit harsh.
You want justice, Lord Royce. I can hardly complain about that. I want the same.
Not much justice to be meted out in suicide, is there?
For Lysa, no, but for her son. And only 20 years ago, the Knights of the Vale rode behind John Arryn, Ned Stark, Robert Baratheon. They fought together to overcome the Mad King. Since then, Arryn and Royce, Corbray, Waynewood, all the great houses of the Vale watched from the corner of a timid boy at a tavern brawl.
Are you questioning our courage?
So I wonder if that's the place where Tyrone Lannister is brought there.
The house that executed your friend Ned Stark.
Well, and you put him in that dungeon with the walls. Nobody was down.
By staying out of the fray, you've allowed Tywin Lannister to destroy his rivals on every compass point. Who stands against him now?
Who would you have us back, Lord Baelish? Robb Stark is dead.
I'd have you back. Robin Arryn, Lord of the Vale.
Robin Arryn is a sickly little boy.
And sickly little boys sometimes become powerful men.
More often, they die young.
Aye.
Ever presume to touch me again or speak my name.
You have until dusk to collect your things and leave this city. If you found a marine past break of day, I'll have your head thrown into Slaver's Bay.
Oh, come on. So I'm leaving then. Ah, yes. Made a little mistake. It makes it big, telling your secrets and all that to the enemy, but it was ages ago.
Mo Kaelin is yours, father.
Walk with me. Has there been any words
from kill you, maybe?
No.
Unimportant. A cripple, a young boy. None of the northern lords have seen them. Dead, most likely. Most of the Ironborn have fled the north. Now more will follow. Thanks to you. Tell me what you see.
See the open land.
Moors, fields, hills.
Tell me what you see.
Nothing.
Not nothing. The north. Right, 700 miles that way, you're still in the north. 400 miles that way. 300 miles that way. The north is larger than the other six kingdoms combined.
Eyes when he knew it was over.
Aye. Nothing in the world beats that look.
You protected him for most of his life. You think you could have saved him?
It wasn't the damn wine taster. Little shit deserved to die, but... Poison... Poison's a woman's weapon. Men kill the steel.
That's your stupid pride talking. That's why you'll never be a great killer. I'd have killed Joffrey with a chicken bone if I had to.
I'd pay good money to see that.
You should have let me burn it.
It's a flea bite.
That flea bite's got you walking a lot slower than you.
Well, we won't have to walk too much further.
So I'm guessing he'll die soon.
Do you think my aunt will pay for me?
Aye, she'll pay.
I've never even met her.
Not sure what she's did.
Doesn't matter. You're her blood. Family, honor, all that horseshit. It's all you lords and ladies ever
talk about. Dead.
I'm not a lady.
Who would pass the bloody gate?
The bloody hound, Sandor Clegane, and his traveling companion, Arya Stark, niece of your lady Lysa Arryn.
Trial by combat. Deciding a man's guilt or innocence in the eyes of the gods by having two other men hack each other to pieces tells you something about the gods. How much longer?
To see the fate.
You think Oberyn has a chance? Red Viper of Dawn. You don't get a name like that unless you're deadly, right?
Never seen him fight.
Oh, he's going to die. I'm going to die.
Oberyn believes in himself.
That's putting it mildly. What's the punishment for regicide? Drawing and quartering? Hanging? Breaking at the wheel?
Beheading. Seems rather ordinary. And he's my nephew as well. Fratricide is brothers. Filicide is
around the world. Men, women and children are murdered by the school. Who gives a dusty fuck about a bunch of beasts?
I know, but still, it filled me with dread. Piles and piles of them, years and years of them.
How many countless living crawling things smashed and dried out and returned to the dirt? In my dreams, I found myself standing on a beach made of beetle husks, stretching as far as the eye could see.
Beetle graves.
Crying, weeping, just shattered little eyes. Tried to stop Orson once.
He was twice your size.
He just pushed me aside with a coup. Kept on smashing. Every day, until that mule kicked him in the chest and killed him.
Oh well. Don't kill him. That'd be his way to die.
So what do you think? Why did he do it? What was it all about?
Power. Control.
I don't know.
Oh, at least they didn't kill the beetle, never. Is this the fight? Yep, this is near the end yet, so this is the fight. Mountain vs. the Viper. This episode's called. Mountain's a big guy, the Viper's one he got. Tyrant, he got
like
to help him.
Armor.
I like to move around.
You could at least wear a helmet. You shouldn't drink before a fight.
You learned this during your years in the fighting pits. I always drink before a fight.
It could get you killed. It could get me killed.
Today is not the day I die.
At least he knows his destiny. It's not his day to die, so... Some dead man? Oh.
I am the brother of Elia Martel. And you know why I come all the way to this stinking shit pile of a city? For you?
Oh.
I'm going to hear you confess before you die. You raped my sister. You murdered her. You killed her children. Say it now, and we can make this quick.
All right, that's my vendetta against him.
Say it.
You raped her? You murdered her?
You killed her children.
Maybe dancing, hang fight dance. That's right. The acrobat's moves. He's playing Moon Joss.
You murdered her!
You can probably kill him anytime he wants. Oh! Speed! Wow! Oh! He's got a weapon now. The sword him. Oh, stab.
Rape her. You murdered her.
Just stab him. Oh, snag.
You
guns, right. Guns down. Dead.
Wait,
the Viper conquered the mountain.
No, no, you can't die yet. You haven't confessed. Say it. Say her name. Elia Martel. You raped her. You killed her children. Elia Martel. Who gave you the order? Who gave you the order? Say her name. You raped her! You murdered her! You killed her children! Say it. Say her name. Say it!
Oh! Oh my god, what's that? Oh!
Earlier marked out.
Children
that are raped back. That are smashed their head in like this.
Stab him! Chiron! Oh my god!
Gods have made their will known. Tyrion Lannister, in the name of King Tommen of the House Baratheon, first of his name, you are hereby sentenced to death.
Hello, guys, dead too, you know. He shouldn't. Tyrion Lannister shouldn't be executed. That guy killed the mountain. Flushed. You actually killed him. Then somehow he got up. It popped his head like a watermelon. Oh my god. See his head's black. Oof. Oh, that was scary. Confess. Confess. And as soon as he did confess, it's black. Wonder what Jamie's going to do this then. Oofed. No, do well. Anyway, enough of this ending. But during the half of it, it was funny. Where the dog took Arya to see her auntie. And to get the bounty for her. But then it turns out her auntie Eliza died 3 days ago. Me Arya was laughing, she did. Cause it. You can take her all that away. Take her all that away to get a bounty from one person and they would end up dead of a family. Then to go to her auntie and her auntie turns out to be dead. We are, must be having a life of a time. Well, everybody, this is for this reaction and I'll see you next time for the Watchers on the Wall. Till then, bye.